Okay, so with your Monarch Watch tagging kit, it's gonna come with sheets of these plastic tags, as well as your data sheet. The data sheet is what you fill in, and then at the end of your tagging season, turn it into Monarch Watch in order to provide data for them when they do hopefully recover your butterflies. The first thing that you want to fill out on your data sheet is the tag number. So your tag number is going to have a series of three letters and then a series of three to four numbers afterwards. You need to provide all of that information for each tag written down. And all of that information is on the tag itself. Then for each tag, you need to record the date, not the date that you're tagging, but the date that the butterfly is going to be released. Whether it's a male and a female, which I'll show you in a second. Whether it was reared, in other words, you grew the caterpillar in captivity, or whether it was a wild butterfly, in other words, you caught it, tagged it, and then released it. And then the tagging location, including the city, the state, and the zip code. Each tag sheet is on basically a piece of wax paper, but it's really important that you don't touch the back of the tag. That's sticky, and that's what's gonna hold the tag onto the Monarch for its 3,000 mile plus journey. So in this case, I'm using just the end of a paper clip. A toothpick works really well. And you can bend back the sheet so that a little bit of the tag goes on, and then just slightly get it onto the paper clip. It's okay if you touch the front of the tag, but you want to avoid touching the back, because then the sticky substance on the back is going to come off. So I like to get the tags off and ready before I grab the butterfly. It makes it a lot easier if you're working with just yourself. If you have a person helping you out, they can prepare the tags while you're grabbing the butterfly, getting it ready to tag. So the first thing you want to see is whether it's a male or a female. Males have these pouches on their hind wings, these two black pouches. Females won't have those pouches, so that's something that you would want to record on your data sheet. In order to hold the butterfly most safely, you want to gently grab both the forewings and the hind wings together. This won't hurt the butterfly, and it's the safest way to hold them. The next thing, so you want to find on the hind wing the cells that look kind of like a mitten. That's where your tag is going to go. So then actually tagging the Monarch is as easy as taking your paper clip with the tag on it, slipping it into that region, and then holding the tag down for 2 to 3 seconds. That'll be enough for it to adhere to the wings, and your butterfly is now tagged. All right, so each Monarch Watch tag has an email address for people when they recover them to report it, as well as a phone number, the name Monarch Watch, as well as that unique tag number. The letters TLN, they change the letters every year so that tags don't get confused. And then each individual Monarch will have a unique identification number. So if somebody finds these anywhere during the migration, they can call in or email to Monarch Watch and report that individual. And since you turned in your data sheets that have the city and the date where the Monarch was released, you can get all of that data, how far it flew, and when it was released.